There's a war going on outside no man is safe from. And dragons may be the key to winning it. No, I'm not talking about the war in Westeros. I'm talking about a microscopic war taking place inside our bodies. But I am talking about real dragons. This is Dr. Van Hoek. She and her colleague, Dr. Bishop, are hoping to use dragon's blood to treat serious infections.
Komodo dragons are beautiful. These animals have survived basically in the form in which you find them now for millions and millions of years of evolution.
These scientists are using Komodo dragon blood to fight what the media are calling superbugs, basically antibiotic-resistant bacteria. So far, we know of 12 superbugs that have evolved resistance to almost all known antibiotics. And yet, the rate at which we're creating new antibiotics is slow. In response, scientists are looking to the natural world to find undiscovered antibiotics.
So in this project, we developed a special process that we call the bioprospector process, where we go prospecting in nature, in this case in the blood of the Komodo dragon, to find interesting peptides.
Bioprospecting is a relatively old term. Our approach is different from traditional method because biological samples are analyzed here, extremely small samples. That's how much blood we're using for our analysis, right? We worked with two samples of 100 microliters of plasma to try finding these new antimicrobial peptides.
So these peptides are part of what's called innate immunity. That's the part of your immune system that keeps you alive in the 2 weeks before your body can make antibodies to things. In the natural world, plants and other organisms make molecules that can kill bacteria of all different kinds. So we thought it would be a good starting point to look in nature for an antimicrobial peptide that we could then modify to make it just a little bit better than what it does normally. This was mostly Barney's idea, to look in the Komodo dragons. I said, that's crazy. Why would we do that? And he said,
so there's a lot of gaps in our knowledge of the immune response in reptiles. Here we have animals like the Komodo dragon who have really robust immune systems.
And they're cool.
They're an impressive animal.
Treating the peptides from the Komodo dragon blood required special particles designed by Dr. Bishop.
Kind of like panning for gold. We take our particles, the particles capture the things that we're interested in, and then we analyze them by mass spectrometer in large scale.
Once Dr. Bishop is done with his analysis, he hands these peptides over to Dr. Van Hoek, who then tests these peptides against various pathogens. The process is called gating. To move forward, the peptide had to kill both Staphylococcus and Pseudomonas, and also prevent the production of biofilm, sticky colonies of bacteria that protect against antibiotics. If a peptide passes all these initial gates, it then moves on to animal testing. Dr. Van Hoek ran 48 peptides through this gating process, and one emerged. That became the basis of a new synthetic peptide that was shown not only to kill these bacteria, but also promote wound healing in lab mice. And guess what they named it?
Because we were honoring the Komodo dragon, we called it Dragon One.
Some of the articles written about our research made the reference to Game of Thrones, which is kind of neat to see that.
Barney's a very big fan of Game of Thrones.
I watched Game of Thrones. I really like the show. It's kind of appeals to that childhood fantasy. You see a dragon. What more can you ask for?
I do not watch Game of Thrones. But one of the things I would say from our work is that the blood of the Komodo dragon, it might not be magical, but it does have these amazing antimicrobial peptides in it. And studying the natural world through science, that's pretty magical.